everyone, welcome back to Fire Emblem Heroes. So today we have a new showcase to do, and I figured that since Legendary Yulia is the focus for the Black Friday deals, that since we didn't have a showcase on air, why not do it? I thought that we had one, but back then I didn't remember that we did it on Resplendent Yulia, not Legendary Yulia, so you can see the confusion that I had here. Legendary Yulia is actually similar to the normal Yulia, but with a very focused kit all around her weapon and also a very good exclusive B skill. So you might say that her build can actually only go in one direction, and it is mostly true. We will see later that her build is already ready to fight and doesn't really need anything at all. But I managed to come up with two builds. One is a slight variation of the base build, and the second one is an entirely new build made from my head and that might very well not work, but we will see later in the gameplay showcase. So, for Fire Emblem guys, news for this week are that we should have a new mythical banner. I will try to roll it on the extra orbs that I got from not rolling on the previous banner, which I felt like was kinda bad, if I'm honest with you guys. And then after that we should get the new book next week, and also with it a new free unit that should also be on the gacha. So, as usual, much like I did with Peony, I will roll on that gacha for sure. And there will also be a Forging Bonds, so fan of Forging Bonds will enjoy that also, I guess. But for now guys, let's focus on the showcase. This is the Yulia from the end of the Genealogy of the Holy War. She's a very pretty and also good unit to have. So if you want to get her for the Black Friday deal, let's see if this showcase manages to convince you, or maybe not convince you to get her. Let me know in the comments either way. Remember as usual that we will go through dialogue, art and other stuff before we get into the build showcase where I will pick it up and tell you guys how it works. And then after that a gameplay showcase with two of her builds that I showed you into the build showcase itself. Once again, thank you very much for watching and hopefully you enjoy the showcase itself. So let's jump straight into it. So here we are with Legendary Yulia. She's an infantry blue tome and she's also a very good dragon killer, which we will see later why, but it is Yulia, so nothing too surprising. For the statline we have HP 40 on the average, attack 56 on the average I say, speed 28, kinda low, but it also means that she will have to rely on her attack for one huge big hit. Then we have death 22, also kinda low and also an asset, so it could be even lower. This kinda means that you will have to put her behind the security to not have her get hit from bows or other stuff. And then you have rest 33. Rather high, which means that she can take a hit from mages and other things that deal magical damage. So it is also a flow, which means that it could be even higher. Overall, how do I see her? She can probably fit only two roles by now: Dragon Killer or a very niche mage tank where you want her to be behind your other units to take hits from mages but also dish them out, which is the third build that basically I based this idea around, which I hope that it will work. If it doesn't, you can use the base build very well, it works wonderfully. let's see what she has to offer with her base build, however. So, the base build, I can tell you, is based all around the weapon. I'd say based 20 times, but you will understand why very quickly. Virtus Naga, effective against Dragon Foes, not too surprising since it is a Naga Tome. Grants attack plus 3. At start of combat, if unit attack is higher than full attack, she gets attack RS plus 6 during combat. So, it means that you want to get abilities that trigger before combat, so that the check can trigger always, because, for example, Mirror Impact, while a very good skill for any kind of mages, it triggers when unit initiates combat, so before... It doesn't happen before the check for Virtus Naga, which means that the extra 6th attack that you get from this don't count in this check. Does it mean that you have to replace the Mirror Impact? Maybe. If you want to do it, it is not a bad choice just to trigger the Virtus Naga, but remember that you always get attack plus 6 and rest plus 10 from here, so maybe you have to value which one you feel like it is better. You also get the fact that the foe cannot make a follow-up attack, so that also is a very good ability to destroy mages on the enemy side. Overall, I feel like this is meant to be a dragon killer, so you can tell why those two are paired up together, since you don't want dragons to make a follow-up attack against you. But I feel like you can make some sort of good way to make Virtus Naga work if you add, for example, Fury on the A or any kind of Life or Death ability, which we'll see is on the first build, of course. Then we have Dragon Fang, boosted damage by 50% of unit attack. So let's say Virtus Naga trigger and Mirror Impact trigger, you have 12 plus attack. Then you also have attack and res ult 3, which means that you get another 5 extra attack. The damage from Dragon Fang should be very, very high. So it is no brainer that she got a really good special like this. You could also run Moonbow, I feel like it could also work for more fast hits, but remember that Yulia is based all around one huge hit to destroy the enemies. Then we have her special ability, which is Light and Dark. Inflicts attack, speed, death and res minus 2 on foe, neutralizes foe bonuses, and disable foe skills that calculate damage using the lower of foe death or res during combat. So this is basically a debuff, a debuffer, and also a killer for the dragon weapons, which is where you mostly find the calculated damage, etc, etc, wording. I'd say this is crucial to any of her builds. It is a very, very, very good ability, because it makes you able to have the check for Naga more easily, since you disable all the buff on the attack, and it also grants you a little bit of viability against the enemy, since you lower each of their stats, which it isn't a bad thing at all, guys. Debuffing really helps most units in the game, so make sure to run it. Overall, as you can see, this build is very self-sustained. You don't need anything else to her kit. Maybe, as I said, you could add Fury or Life or Death here to trigger the Virtus Naga more easily, but I wouldn't say that it is necessary at all. I added Death Blow for the same reason of Mirror Impact. I feel like Virtus Naga can trigger or not trigger, it won't make the difference most of the time. Yulia is meant to kill dragons, she's not meant to kill most other units, which is kind of a shame, but also kind of an issue that she does very well, since she can kill most of the recent dragon that released, much like Female Grima Halloween or Halloween the Ginsea, so I'd say that she's a unit worth to have. But can you improve her kit and maybe bring her to another direction? Let's see, with the first build, Naga Faithful. So you can see that I change only two things here, mainly because, as I said earlier, she's very self-sustained, so she doesn't need much changes in her build. This build tries to make the Virtus Naga work better by adding Fury 3, which means that you lose 3 attack overall, since you gain 6 attack from here and 3 from here, but you lose the 6 from the impact, which means that you gain overall 6 attack, but you gain probably some extra viability, since Fury overall gives you more stats than Mirror Impact overall, let's say. In total, it shouldn't. Then we have Brazen Attack and Res. This actually works very well to trigger Virtus Naga, so if you want to replace it here you will do it very well, but I feel like this is paired up with the Fury, so it makes sense to have compared to the previous build. I'd say this one maybe works a little bit better, which is why it could be in the gameplay showcase, but Fury is always an ability that I don't like to use because of the damage, since if the unit can't self-sustain itself in HP, most of the time they will only die. I'd say that Life or Death I prefer better, since she already has trash defenses except for S, so she can make it work a little bit better, especially with the fact that she gets a ton of res from the Attack and Res Hot, Light and Dark and Virtus Naga overall. Ok, last but not least, we have the Princess build. This build came up when I thought about making Yulia a mage tank and I saw some of the blue domes and I thought that Blur Owl Plus worked better. Why? This weapon grants Yulia attack, speed, death and res by number of adjacent allies per 2, so it means that at most she can get 6. Which is not bad at all, because it means that you basically get an all Virtus Naga on every stat that Yulia can have. However, it removes the Dragon Killer effect, which makes her, as I said, a little more different from the base objective of her kit. Does it make her bad? Not at all, because if you get 6 on every stat, she gets a very good stat line overall. I also went for Glacis, since if you make the mat with Blur Owl plus Mirror Impact and Attack and Res Hot, whenever you have Glacis ready, you can do an crazy amount of damage with Yulia. So, I'd say this build kinda is aimed around the fact that she has to be a princess, so protected from her knights, where she will deal crazy damage behind their back. And hopefully we will make it work by using Legendary Selif as her guard. If you guys want to check it out in action, we will do it later in the gameplay showcase. I feel like it can work very well, but once again I will repeat that this build isn't the main job for Yulia. She's meant to be a Dragon Killer, and the Naga Faithful build is more suited for her overall design as a hero. So I suggest that you go for Naga Faithful if you prefer, rather than this build. This build is more of a test that I wanted to do with Yulia that might work or might not work. We will see in the gameplay showcase. So, thank you very much once again for joining me in this build discussion. Hopefully you guys enjoy it. Yulia is one of my favorite heroes in this game, so I am glad that she has already 2 showcases. Hopefully 3 whenever we get the Fallen version. I also wanted to tell you guys to tune in later this week for the Mythical Banner. We will try to roll with any excess orbs that we have, and hopefully you will be there to see me failing, because that's what happens in every Mythical Banner. But who knows, maybe we will get the hero. If you do, of course, there will be a showcase on that hero. If not, we will postpone it for another time whenever we get it, and do a showcase on someone else earlier next week at the Wars. So thank you very much for joining me, guys. Remember to leave a like and a sub. Remember to wait to see the gameplay showcase for the 2 builds that I made for Yulia. And also remember to tune in next time for another wonderful showcase. So now, I bid you farewell. I leave you with Legendary Yulia for the gameplay showcase. I can.
I'll do all I can.
I understand. So far. Yummy! What? How lovely. I will do what I can. Ha! Where to?
I'll bear this legacy.
What?
Let's try that.
Sansa! Did I scare you?
I'll bear this legacy.
I understand. This feeling, this power. What?
Do all I can.
I will do what I can. Where to? So far.
Let's try that.
Oh, what? Mmm, yummy. Oh, but I understand. Oh. I will do what I can. Yeah! Mmm, sun's up. Mmm, how lovely. Oh, what?
It's come to this.
I'll bear this legacy.
Where to? I will do what I can. So far. Understand. Boo! Did I scare you? What? Yeah.
I'll do all I can. The world made new!